And regulates qi and blood by transmitting through the meridians. Just like acupuncture, moxibustion was invented as a result of medical practices and life experiences of the Chinese people. Tracing back to ancient times, we find that even the branch of the mulberry or the seedlings of the peach tree were used in moxibustion treatments. It is capable of bridging the channel passage, expelling the cold and dampness, and recuperating the depleted yang to protect the patient from illness. Moxibustion can be made by processing the fresh artemisia leaf.
Because
of different production processes, moxa wool can be divided into thin and thick. The moxa wool, which is light and fluffy, is always considered high quality, while a hard or loose one suggests the opposite and often causes scalding of the skin when it is used. Generally, old moxa wools function better than the new ones. Moxa wool should be preserved in a dry container. Commonly used moxibustion treatments are as follows. Moxibustion with moxa cones. Moxibustion with moxa sticks. Moxibustion with warming needle. Moxibustion with mild moxibustioner. Crude herb moxibustion. Morning rush moxibustion. At the very outset, we would like to introduce moxibustion therapies with moxa cones. The moxa cone is cone-shaped, and when a moxa cone expires, we say that we have finished one unit. In clinical assessment, the operator can increase or reduce the degree of stimulation by adjusting the size of the moxa cone. A moxa cone is made by hand-kneading the moxa wool or pressing them with a special instrument. The smallest is the size of a grain of wheat, and the largest the size of the upper part of the thumb. Moxibustion with moxa cones can be direct, or indirect.
Placing
a moxa cone directly on the point to be ignited is called direct moxibustion or open moxibustion. Prior to moxibustion, relax the patient and make him comfortable by proper body aligning and positioning, and applying some Vaseline or garlic juice to the site to increase the adhesion of the moxa cone on the skin. Then put the moxa cone on the point and ignite it. When the patient feels a burning sensation, replace the cone with a new one. The local skin should turn red instead of showing any blister. This method is called non-scarring moxibustion.
Indications are diseases of conditions and cold nature. A cotton ball and a medicated adhesive strip should be prepared before festering moxibustion. Festering moxibustion is administered by putting the cone on the point and igniting it until it completely expires, and patting the local region around the point when the cone is about to burn the skin in order to release pain. Wipe the local region with a cold gauze after a moxicone expires and then put on another one. Repeat the procedure several times, then stick the medicated adhesive strip on the points. Change the strip every day, and after a few days, a non-bacteria festering reaction will appear. A scar will form in about a month. Therefore, the festering moxibustion is also called scarring moxibustion. During the festering period, patients are advised to adopt a nutritious diet, rest, and keep the local region clean to avoid infection, or dress the moxibustion area till the scar is formed. This is suitable for a patient who is weak or suffering from certain chronic diseases such as asthma or gastroenteritis.
The
wheat grain moxibustion is often more acceptable for the patient. The moxicone used in this method is made in the size of a grain of wheat. Indications are diseases of deficiency of qi and blood, dizziness, or common warts. Indirect moxibustion can be further divided into several types according to the material placed between the moxicone and the skin. Moxibustion with ginger. Cut a slice of ginger about half a centimeter thick. Punch a number of holes in it and place it on the point selected. On top of it, a moxicone is placed and ignited. Is indicated for symptoms caused by weakness and yang deficiency, such as diarrhea, abdominal pain, and painful joints. When the patient feels a scorching sensation, put a piece of paper between the ginger and skin, then continue the treatment until the local skin turns red. Moxibustion with garlic. Cut a slice of garlic. A larger single clove of garlic is desirable. Put it on the point with the ignited moxicone above. This method is indicated for scrofula, tuberculosis, early stage skin ulcer, etc. Besides the method mentioned above, there is another moxibustion method with garlic, which is called spreading moxibustion, or long snake moxibustion. Use 500 grams of paired mashed garlic. Garlic should be as fine and smooth as cream. While operating, adopt the prone posture, expose the patient's back, and make him comfortable.